Why is Rocket League so good? Rocket League is one of the most successful sports games today, and there really isn't anything like it. In this video, I will explain why Rocket League is so popular today and how it got here. So in July 2015, the company released something that would change sports games forever. A soccer game with cars. Now this doesn't sound that interesting on paper, but it's what you can do with the cars that make it so fun. Like in 2K or FIFA, it was so hard to emulate the real life aspect of shooting or passing and dribbling. So what do? They made it easy just by making you press a button to do all these things. For example, in 2K, the skill gap is so small because the game is mostly based on luck. In Rocket League, it feels like a whole new area in gaming was discovered. They found a way to make shooting and passing feel like you were in control of the ball. It made it feel realistic because you can control how high, fast, and where the ball was going. It's like they literally invented a new sport and a whole new part of gaming. Another thing that makes Rocket League fun and different is the skill gap. With the abilities like jump, boost, roll, and flip, players found a whole new way to play Rocket League, and that's areals. You just couldn't do anything other than play the game normally in other sports games. This is the reason why Rocket League is so successful in esports. Movement is another thing why Rocket League is so successful. A keyboard and mouse or a controller is similar to a car because of what a car can do. Move four directions. A human can do a whole 360 motion without breaking a sweat. The boost mechanic is really what defines Rocket League though, because it's the reason why there's so much variety when it comes to movement in the air. Yet this game is so simple with one goal in mind, and that's to score the most points. The game doesn't need a meta or new updates because it's so good at the way it is. This is the reason why it has no glitches. It has been perfected ever since launch. It doesn't need all new fancy maps or anything to add on to the simple gameplay. Some 10-year-old can have as much fun as a 20-year-old in this game. It just works and you're 100% in control of it. Now, the competitive part of Rocket League has been around for 5 years and everyone would say it's the most balanced, to the point that if you lose a game, you just know that the other team is just better, period. There isn't any RNG like in Fortnite where players complain all the time that they got bad loot from a chest. In Rocket League, your skill is your skill, and if you're grinding every day for hours, you will see an improvement in your gameplay no matter what happens. In FPS shooters, even the most competitive ones like CSGO, you might not see someone due to them camping. But in Rocket League, there really isn't an excuse, because you have all the information you need. You just have to control your car better. It isn't like you can unlock better cars that will make you a better player. The game's literally 0% play to win, and the only thing that I guess you can say is pay to win is getting better technology or better internet. Nothing is pay to win in this game. So when players get better, it isn't because they have a coach or something. Most players find things out by playing the game for hours and hours. Like for example, they accidentally hit the ball from the wall to the goal, and that's how they know more about that specific angle. Rocket League is so geometric that anything the ball does is because of you, the enemy, or the environment. There isn't any magic around it. Players grind for hundreds of hours, and even the best of the best are still discovering new things to do because the game has such a high skill ceiling. Not to worry though, because this game is such a good time killer due to how many scenarios happen every time you play, and every game is different. Finally, Rocket League is the most available game ever, I would say. It went from free to play in 2020 and has cross-platform. It got no violence, and who isn't into all the new ways of gaming, supporting everything from casual to competitive to esports. What do you think about this topic? If you want to learn more about gaming, or you just want to know more about games, subscribe. I post videos weekly, and you'll be missing out on a ton of things you might want to know about gaming. Thanks for watching, and let's have a discussion about this in the comments below.